What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to TTC, and in this video, Charles and I are going to be sitting down and asking ChatGPT the most commonly asked day trading questions. So let's get right into it. All right, so let's just hop right into it. And right off the bat, we should just discuss what ChatGPT is briefly, if you're unfamiliar. ChatGPT is basically just a, it's an AI developed by the company OpenAI, and they use, I believe, over millions of layers in their neural network, something like that, and it's trained on massive amounts of data. But it is a bit lagging because as of the date of recording, it's only current up until the end of 2021. But, you know, nonetheless, it's still phenomenal. Charles, anything you want to say about ChatGPT before we get started?
I guess just maybe to dumb it down a little bit, like, for those who don't know what a neural network is or, like, what a layer in a neural network is or anything like that, basically ChatGPT, the people who coded it, they just made it very big. And all it does is it just goes through and it looks at stuff that it might find on the internet as it relates to a different topic that you might ask it. So it'll just go scroll Google, read a lot of blogs for you, learn from those blogs very quickly, and then spit that information back to you. So, yeah.
So yeah, let's get right into it. So the first question, pretty basic question that I feel like a lot of people ask is day trading profitable? So the answer is given. Day trading can be profitable for some people, but it is not a guaranteed way to make money. Day trading involves buying and selling financial instruments such as stocks within the same trading day. The goal is to profit from short-term fluctuations in the market. Successful day traders often have extensive knowledge of the market, strong analytical skills, and the ability to make quick decisions. They also typically use technical analysis tools and strategies to identify patterns and trends in the market, yada, yada, yada. However, day trading can also be very risky, especially for inexperienced traders who do not have the necessary skills and knowledge. It requires a significant amount of time and effort, and there's a possibility of losing money as well. Additionally, day trading involves high trading fees such as broker fees and commissions, which can eat into profits. In conclusion, day trading can be profitable for those who have the necessary skills and knowledge, but it is not a guaranteed way to make money and comes with significant risks. It is important to thoroughly research and understand the market and risks before deciding to engage in day trading. So that's kind of a lot, but as a day trader yourself, and somebody who's been profitable, what do you take from this definition? What do you like about this answer? What do you dislike?
I mean, I don't see anything wrong with it. The only thing I would say is, like, I think, and I don't know that I would ask ChatGPT to do this anyway, but, like, you know, kind of just an understanding of, like, what skills and all that. And I think as well, like, the idea that they're, like, typically technical analysis, I wouldn't say I take issue with it. I just would say, like, that's a hard thing to guarantee, just because it's, like, it's hard to say what is, like, technical analysis. Like, you could throw a lot of definitions. You could ask ChatGPT right now, and I guarantee if you put 10 people in a room, they might debate you on that definition here or there or what have you. So I think saying that, maybe, but I don't think there's anything wrong with what it said. Obviously, I think it's just, you know, it's kind of given the quick and dirty, and, like, obviously there's way more to it, because, you know, just saying you got to have the necessary skills and all that kind of stuff without saying what that is. Yeah, I mean, but that's not really what you asked it, right? So
so I agree with what you're saying. Like, I think it's kind of like a very bland answer, because, like, that's like with anything, right? Like, how do I become a very good basketball player? I mean, you can be a very good basketball player if you have the necessary skills and knowledge, but if you don't, you know what I mean? Like, it's a very basic answer that can be applied to everything, like if you're just giving advice about anything. And I wish it did come, like, give a bit more specificity and being like, well, you should work on your mindset. You should work on these different things, having a schedule, being able to track, whatever. Like, whatever the skills are that make would make them be successful. I wish it delved into that more. But like you said, that's not the question I asked it. I asked it a very, like, simple question, and we got a very simple answer. So moving on to the next question. How do I start day trading? All right, so it gives seven basic steps on how to start day trading. First one, learn about the markets. Second, develop a trading strategy. Three, choosing a broker. Four, practice with a demo account. Five, start with a small amount of capital. Six, monitor your trades. And seven, manage risk. Overall, day trading requires a significant amount of time, effort, and research. It is essential to approach it with discipline, strategic mindset, and to manage your risk carefully. Thoughts?
I mean, again, I think it's not a bad definition. I would maybe disagree with the order of it, or maybe certain things go inside another category that I wasn't a part of. Like, for example, like, I think the manage risk aspect could definitely go under the whole, you know, develop a strategy type thing. But I mean, as a whole, again, there's nothing wrong with that definition. I think it's pretty sound. But again, I think that goes back to like what we were talking about in terms of like ChatGPT, in terms of what it's made to do and how it works. Like, there's like millions of blogs out there that people have said this exact same thing. So I'm not really surprised it's bringing that back. So.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing to me is, like, it kind of seems that, like, there's seven steps, right? It's kind of making it seem as though, like, each step is equal to another step, if that makes sense. Like, you're going to spend way more time on learning the markets and developing a trading strategy than you are on choosing a broker. You know what I mean? Like, they're not all equal steps. And that's the only thing that, like, stood out to me. Anyway. Anyways, next question. What book should you read to start day trading? And I know we probably have some books that we would recommend, but I want to see what ChatGPT recommends. What book should you read to start day trading? All right, so it gives five recommendations. The first, How to Day Trade for a Living by Andrew Aziz. Second, a beginner's Guide to Day Trading Online by Tony Turner. Third, The Complete Guide to Day Trading by Marcus Heitkoder and Mark Hodge. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Four, Trading in the Zone by Mark Douglas. And five, Mastering the Trade by John F. Carter. I mean, I'm not really gonna ask you your thoughts, because obviously these are very good books, but like, I'm gonna ask you, what are other books that you would recommend that aren't on this list that it didn't recommend?
I like Trading Psychology 2.0 by Brett Steenbarger. It's basically a very good book about like taking trade, like everybody talks about like treat your trading like a business, do this, you know, in terms of like look at your mindset, look at your emotions, but never really give you any like hard ways to do that. Gives you a lot of different possibilities on things that you could try out doing that. So I think Trading Psychology 2.0. I also like Trading Beyond the Matrix by, I think his last name's like Van Tharp or something like that. But Trading Beyond the Matrix is also really And then also the mental game of trading. Obviously, one had said already, like trading in the zone as well, but I would say those other three. And then I would say the last one that's not like trading specific, but I think it's very good for like traders. It's this book, and I can't think of the name of the author right now, but it's this book called The Chimp Paradox. And basically just talks about this idea of not really fighting your more evolutionary or more reactive brain, but just kind of understanding it, understanding why it's there. And if you understand why it's there and what its purpose is, you know, you can kind of understand why it does what it does or has the thoughts that it has that sometimes you can't control, you know, and all that kind of stuff. And if you understand these things, it's maybe a little bit easier for you to monitor it. And it makes understanding all this kind of stuff makes it easier to do a lot of the other stuff that you'll read in the more trading specific books where they talk about looking at your emotions, monitoring this, monitoring that. You know what I mean? If you don't know how to like look at your mind outside the trading space, it can be kind of difficult to do that just in the trading space all of a sudden. So I would say those four, right? Yeah.
Yeah, and I like that you brought up a book that isn't necessarily trading focused, but would definitely help you with your trading, because I was going to bring up The Mindful Athlete. And that's, again, that's a book that has nothing to do with trading specifically, but, you know, it's something that teaches you about your mentality and your mind and how you can react to situations. And as a trader, your whole life is basically reacting, right? Like, I know we've talked about this plenty of times, and for you all watching, if you want to see some of those conversations, go look at our old podcast videos. We talked about these topics like a lot, but yeah, that book, basically the biggest idea from that book that I got was that there's a gap between when you experience something and then your the way that you respond to it. So within that gap, you can decide on how you want to respond to that thing, right? So, and that can apply to trading in many different ways, as we've talked about before. But again, I'm just really happy that you brought that up, because these books are about day trading specifically, there are other books that can help you as a day trader if you learn more about like human nature and like human psychology and like your mindset and things like that. Anyways, moving on to the next question: how risky is trading? All right, so I actually really like this answer, because when talking about risk in day trading, I feel like only maybe one or two of these are actually brought up instead of all five of these, right? So ChatGPT basically gave us a list of five different types of risk associated with day trading. So there's market risk, there's liquidity risk, the margin risk, trading cost risk, and emotional risk. And I mean, before I keep going, do you have anything you want to say about that? Because I actually like really like that it broke it down like that.
No, I mean, I don't have anything. No.
Yeah, I just think, like I was saying, like the only people only really talk about maybe market risk. I've never really heard people mentioning trading cost risk. That's just because depending on the broker that you pick, like you might not have a lot of trading fees, or you might. But it's still something to keep in mind, right? When I first started actually trading, I was just trading demo for a while, paper trading. And then when I first started actually trading, like that's one thing that I didn't even like consider, right? Just like just because you made 1% doesn't mean you're gonna have 1%, a 1% gain in your account. You're still gonna lose some from fees and sit different things, right? So there's kind of a learning curve in actually starting to day trade, and like trading cost risk is one of them. Not to say that it's like some huge risk. It's not that.
Yeah, I mean, I think it can only be as big as you want to make it, right? Because I think another thing is a lot of times people say trading costs and they automatically just assume and stick with brokers. But I mean, if you take, for example, like us, like if you use or you try to employ an algorithm, you might have to pay to like keep up a node for that algorithm, that's a trading cost now. Or maybe if you want to like backtest your strategy past a certain date, you might have to pay for, you know, trading view past a certain level, right? And like now that's a different cost. So I think it's, that's another thing you have to consider too, because a lot of these things like we're describing are like monthly fees. So you got to be making sure, you have to make sure that the money that you're making from trading is like making those things make sense. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, if you're talking about treating it like a business, the revenue has to beat your expenses. You're not going to profit. You're going to be operating at a loss. And traders, we don't have like ads that we can sell. So we don't really, we can't really operate at the loss like other businesses can. So, yeah.
But yeah, I really like that answer. Next question is, how much do you need to start trading? Yeah, again, I actually really like this answer. I like how they broke down that it really depends on the instrument that you trade. So, yeah, it definitely depends whether you're trading stocks, Forex, futures, or options. Anything you want to add?
No, I think that's a really good point. Like, I think that's something that I think I was definitely guilty of myself in terms of not really thinking about telling others from that standpoint when they would ask me that question, just because, you know, before I would get into trading something new, I would always think to myself, like, can I even afford to trade this? So it was like a consideration that I assumed other people were already making, but not everybody thinks that way, right? Like people think you can, and you can try to get into trading options with like $1,000 or like $10,000, but it becomes inherently more risky trading some of these, I call them like contract securities, when you don't have enough money to put up all the margin that you might need, right? Because you get a little bit of margin help as it relates to things like with Forex, all that kind of stuff. So I think that is a very important consideration that, you know, I think I'm even guilty of not really telling others to consider. So yeah.
Yeah. One thing I would add to this answer to this question is the fuck, I just lost it. Oh, got it. So yeah, one thing that I would actually add to this answer is yes, you can start trading with a little much, like for Forex, for example, you can start trading Forex with like $50, you can deposit into account, but you're not really gonna be making a lot of profit off of $50, right? So obviously the more money that you have to invest initially or to start trading with, the more money you're gonna make. And that's why something like a prop firm are very like hugely successful and hugely appealing to traders, because, you know, we might not have $100,000 that we can use to trade, but we can trade as if we have that amount of money, and we can make gains on our account as if we have that amount of money, right, without actually having to have it. So that's one thing that I would add to that answer.